Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Now they'll throw with Taylor. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Corey Coleman, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns are able to cash in for six. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. It's up and through to make it 7-0 Browns. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. It's a short kick here, fielded at the 24. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. While we have a minute, we remind you that later tonight we'll have a couple of NFC East rivals squaring off, the Eagles and the Cowboys from Big D.
Or Arlington. Got to make sure we get it right.
To be more precise there in the Metroplex. Then tomorrow night, Week 11, we'll wrap up with a playoff rematch from the divisional round a year ago, the Falcons and Seahawks, but this time from Seattle. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
And Leonard Fournette impressing there with that run. It's hard to believe that no Jacksonville Jaguar has broken 1,000 yards since Maurice Jones-Drew in 2011. And Leonard Fournette could be that guy.
Even with the ankle injury last year at LSU, still averaged 6.5 yards per carry.
And absolutely intimidated opposing defenses. A lot of guys simply didn't want to tackle him.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. On 2nd down, here's Fournette. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. From the gun on 3rd down, Bortles. And he finds Safarian Jenkins. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags 1st down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a 1st down.
Here's a carry for a former starter. This is T.J. Yeldon. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football 1st down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Now Bortles throwing on 2nd down. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. And he doesn't quite make it. They do stop him, but he gets it all the way down to the 1. A gain of 32 that time.
there will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can...
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great play there. His ninth touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs, so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. Now Taylor being chased out left. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
On first down, it's Taylor. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Barry Church. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Now, that was a beautiful play. A pick six. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What, you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
And this one through the uprights and good. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount, here's his opportunity.
It all comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off here by C.O. Moore. And he will take this one home.